that the Lord has made. I'm Karen Colson, your platform assistant this morning, and we'd like to thank everyone who helps to make our Sundays here so successful. That includes everyone in hospitality upstairs, our ushers, script and bookstore, our streaming, sound, PowerPoint, and our youth leaders, and of course, our wonderful music team. If this is your first time here for it, we would like you to fill out a yellow card that you'll find in the pew pocket and leave it with one of the ushers, and we have a small gift for you. We're grateful that you are here with us today. And my welcome also includes all of you at home. Thank you for joining us here today. I do have a few announcements. So next Saturday, we have our Walk to End Homelessness, and it's not too late for you to sign up or to donate to some of our walkers. So check out on the counter in the back or more info in the latest e-zine on how you can sign up for that or how you can sign up to donate. And thank you very much. And then later, Saturday night, we have Chili Bingo here. It begins at 4 o'clock. You need to bring your own play setting and a beautifully wrapped white elephant gift. We also are encouraging Irish costumes because, as you know, that will be St. Paddy's Day weekend celebration, although it's officially on the 17th. And we have a prize for the best dressed costume. So please see at the sign-up sheet, again, at the counter for what you need to bring or to sign up for a gift. I mean, not a gift, but a dish that you might bring to pass. Also, we have directory photos today and next week. So Tom is upstairs after service for those of you who signed up, and there might be some opportunity even if you didn't, and then you can also sign up for next week. So please get your photo taken for our directory. And we have a DEI meeting that will be on Zoom today at 7 p.m. Joe Daly will be sending out a link for that. That is typically held this Sunday after service, but because of our book study, we're having it Zoom tonight instead of in person here at this church. So thank you all for joining. Yeah, Joe?
So if you'd like to attend and you're not on a regular list, just write your email address on a slip of paper and give it to me and I'll make sure you get the link.
Okay, great, thanks. Okay, so today we have Reverend Judy here with us, and her title today of her talk is called The Shower Effect. Sounds very intriguing. Thank you for being here, Judy. We appreciate you. So now everyone, including everyone at home, please join me in our mission statement. As an all-inclusive community, we awaken to spirit, grow into our soul, and build a better world. And our vision statement, celebrate a world of ever-awakening consciousness, abundance, peace, and love for all. And our core values of love, authenticity, stewardship, oneness, and playfulness. All right, I don't see any children in the sanctuary today, so they have either all gone on their own way or have stayed home with their parents. All right. And so next we have Deb with our music into meditation, Raising the Veil.
I'm raising the veil between Good morning, everyone. This is the time when we take a big pause. Take a big pause, a deep breath, and we just simply relax into some quiet time of prayer and meditation. We've had a chance to come together and sing together and express our joy at being together in this place. And now we take that pause and we acknowledge not only our own spiritual energy and Christ presence, but the presence of God within. So the daily word for today is illuminate. Taking a moment to appreciate the beauty of a sunset, I realized that in another part of the world, the first rays of a rising sun are bringing light to a morning sky. Whether I can see it or not, the sun never stops shining. Somewhere, a new day is dawning. Much more brilliantly than the sun, the light of God, too, is always shining. Sometimes my thoughts might be so focused on a challenging life situation that I do not sense this divine light. But then in a flash of insight, I experience again the illuminating presence that even in my darkest moments is as near as my next thought. I affirm, let there be light. I breathe out frustration and worry. Breathing in, I am filled with the light of truth that illuminates my mind and shines from within my heart. And from Genesis chapter 1, verse 3, then God said, let there be light, and there was light. Our affirmation for today is, I welcome the light. I'll say that once again, and then the third time through, I'll invite you to join me. I welcome the light together. I welcome the light. And we do indeed welcome the light. And as we take this time for some prayer and some quiet time on this quiet, snowy morning, we simply turn our thoughts inward to a peaceful place, to that calm centeredness that is the presence of God within. We allow ourselves to rest there quietly, securely, and happily, knowing that we are loved, that we are blessed, and that each one of us is a precious expression of God's light and love and energy and compassion. We are reassured and renewed by our acknowledgement of our true nature and who we are. What we are here for. And how we are to move forward in this world. As a beacon of light, as a glow of love and kindness and compassion And we know that we are a channel through which all of this flows from the divine and into the world. And so I invite you now to simply think about the love that is flowing in and through you, to feel your connection with all that is. And to rest peacefully in the calm assurance that when we live from that space, all is well with us. I invite you now to just spend a few moments in the silence, resting in that peaceful, calm assurance, your oneness with all that is. I invite you now to gently bring your thoughts and your awareness back to this time and this place. And as we go forward with our day and with our week, remember that that illuminating presence, that light and love and peace and compassion, that is God. That is our oneness with everything, is just a thought away. It is a breath away. It is a thought away. And because of that, we can always welcome the light. Amen. So it is. And so we let it be.
Good morning. The song choice, yes, I was tackled by a child gate, so for those of you who are interested. This morning's song choice was inspired by a class I went to a couple weeks ago called How Not to Give a Darn. It turned into a master's course because the instructor didn't show up. So we learned real fast how not to give a darn and to just let it be. Find myself in times of trouble, Mother Mary comes to me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be. And in my hour of darkness, she is standing right in front of me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be. Let it be, let it be, let it be, yeah, let it be. Whisper words of wisdom, let it be. And when the broken-hearted people living in the world agree, there will be an answer, let it be. For though they may be parted, there is still a chance that they will see. There will be an answer, let it be. Let it be, let it be, let it be, yeah, let it be. You're there.
Well, good morning and welcome everyone. Welcome all of you who are joining us online today. We are blessed to have everyone's spiritual energy here with us today. Some of you may be thinking we have a tall visitor and lady friend who are with us today, and that's not true. I just want to give a little bit of a shout out to Rich and Kathy Wiedemeyer, members who go way, well, not that far back, because I remember you, right? You were here when I got here, so yeah. But they're joining us this morning down from the Grand Rapids area. So welcome. It's great to see you all. and welcome anyone else who is here for the first time, if it's only the first time ever, or maybe just the first time in a while. So we're glad you're here. So a Zen master visiting New York City stops at the cart of a hot dog vendor, and he says, "Make me one with everything." Okay, a Zen master stops at the cart of a hot dog vendor and says, "Make me one with everything." Thank you, Dave. Wait for it, right? Wait for it. The hot dog vendor fixes a hot dog and hands it to the Zen master, who pays with a $20 bill. The vendor puts the bill in the cash box and closes the lid. "Excuse me, but where is my change?" says the Zen master. The vendor looks him directly in the eye and very solemnly says, "Change can only come from within." But we seem to be on a roll here, so. So one Zen student said to another, my master has so much self-control, he can go days without sleep. A second student said, my teacher has so much self-control, he can go days without eating. A third student stated, my teacher is so focused that he can go for days without drinking water. The fourth student looks at them all and says, my teacher is the most enlightened. He eats when he's hungry, he sleeps when he's tired, and he drinks when he's thirsty. So the first story was for fun, but the second story is intended to illustrate how we can sometimes really complicate even the most simplest things in life. And my lesson for today is about finding out that we all need that balance between simple and complicated, and understanding why it works to our advantage to have that balance between simple and complicated. Now, since we're all worriers by nature, we're sometimes kind of guilty of creating some of the situations and some of the problems that we struggle with. And even when we're not responsible for creating them, you know, we can make them much worse by jumping headlong into the worst case scenario and playing that vision in our head over and over again. We often refer to that as awfulizing. But have you ever noticed how good a nice hot shower feels when you find yourself all tense and wound up about some situation? I woke up and saw the snow this morning, and I'm telling you, that shower felt real good. Well, researchers have documented that there is such a thing called the shower effect. And they've studied it, and they can help us understand why it works. Not just to warm us up on a cold winter morning, but there's a lot more to it. So let's jump into today's lesson, which is called the shower effect, or as I like to think of it, the magic of mindlessness. Yeah, you heard that right. For every 10 conversations we have about the importance of being mindful, we need to have at least one conversation about the value of mindlessness. And guess what? Today is that day. So here's what the research tells us. People often seem to generate creative ideas during moderately engaging activities, such as showering or walking. One explanation of the shower effect is that creative idea generation requires a balance between focused, linear thinking, which is typically not very creative or original, and completely unbounded blue sky thinking, random associations, those things that we probably would characterize as squirrel moments. So we've all heard the quote from Einstein, which tells us that the level of thinking that created the problem is not the level of thinking that will help us solve the problem. So for solutions, we need to see through a different lens. We need a fresh pair of eyes. We need a different level of thinking. And usually the best solutions are those that don't require us to choose between A or B, but instead allow us to consider C, D, and E, which were probably options that were never even on the table when we first started wrestling with the problem. So these creative ideas have the space to come forward when we move our linear thinking into the background and just allow our minds to wander in the foreground. That's called productive mind wandering. And it's best suited to an environment that requires us to be only moderately engaged or focused on some activity or task at hand. So again, repetitive or routine activities such as taking a shower, washing the dishes, going for a walk, mowing the grass, painting a room, they often provide just the right amount of focus and mind wandering. I was working on this talk and thinking about that when I was folding laundry the other day. You know, it's a relatively mindless activity. You gotta pay attention because you gotta match the socks and all of that other stuff. But, you know, it doesn't require a whole lot of thought. So these activities that we're talking about, again, are mostly mindless. But please, don't ever think of them as a waste of time or just a simple household chore, something you gotta put up with. Because they really do provide some valuable space and the balance that we need to explore the world of possibilities that are available to us each day. I mean, what good is a world of possibilities if we never get to run with the ball? If we're so focused and so linear and so busy and so hyper-vigilant about stuff that we never have a chance to let our minds wander and have one of those really brilliantly creative ideas, the kind of stuff that moves you forward in a quantum sort of a way. There's some spiritual aspects to this too, because for me, the magic of mindlessness, what makes it really kind of a cool thing, is that it actually brings in three of our 12 powers: imagination, will, and order. And it's also a nice balance, again, between creative thinking, linear thinking, and it engages both the left and the right hemispheres of the brain. And that kind of mind-wandering space, where we engage all of those different things together, is really what helps us open some doors, shine some light, illuminate a new path, right? It's that combination of imagination, creative things, and then putting it to work for us by doing something with those ideas. stepping into those possibilities. So, anatomically, the two sides of your brain look pretty much the same, but there's a huge difference in how they process information. So the left brain is more verbal, analytical, and orderly, and it's sometimes called the digital brain because it's better at things like reading, writing, and computations. The right brain tends to be much more visual and intuitive. People sometimes refer to it as the analog brain, but it has a much more creative and less organized way of thinking. Now, each hemisphere is responsible for specific types of thinking and specific body functions, but they don't operate independently of each other. They need to work together in a very highly integrated way in order for us to maintain our physical and mental health and to function in an optimal way. There are bundles of nerve fibers that tie the two hemispheres of the brain together, and it creates kind of an information highway. And although they work differently and they function differently, they do work together. So the time that we spend in prayer and meditation gives us a toll ticket, if you will. It gives us permission to jump on that super highway between our conscious mind and super consciousness. And when we talk about super consciousness, we're really talking about divine mind. That super highway between our consciousness and super consciousness or divine mind transports us into that world of divine wisdom, light, and love. The stuff that really nourishes our hearts and minds. And it moves us into a space where we can really co-create with spirit. Metaphysically, again, it is that path from consciousness to super consciousness. So when we got all those things working together in harmony and in a balanced way, seeds of possibility are planted in the fertile soil of that space. And if we allow our minds to wander as we perform routine tasks or activities, that's just like sunshine and rain for the flowers and the crops and the trees. So the time that we spend in prayer, meditation, and allowing our minds to wander can produce a bumper crop of possibilities for us. It gives us fresh ideas and new perspectives that kind of work like a spiritual GPS to just guide us to our highest and best good. Thoreau describes this magical effect of combining meditation and mind wandering with our powers of imagination, will, and order as success unexpected in common hours. We go way beyond our wildest dreams, right? We get more than we possibly could have imagined. You know, solutions come just like that, stuff that we didn't even know an hour ago, now is there. And it's crystal clear. Who doesn't want that? And if you don't want yours, I'll take it, okay? So, today, I'm inviting you to kind of put all these ideas together and open your hearts and minds to this idea and this awareness of mind wandering as a way to really basically take your cart, walk down the aisle of amazing possibilities and just say, oh yeah, give me some of that, you know, and just put them right in there. That's how good things happen. I want to close with a line from Megan McDonough's song, Amazing Things, right? That's one of my favorites, and we sing that a lot here. In the third verse, she wrote, "Sometimes deepest answers come when you're out there having fun." And I want to add to that, or doing the dishes, or mowing the grass, or folding the laundry, or taking a shower. Okay? So do your chores, take a shower, get your daily dose of magic mindlessness, and you, my friends, will live abundantly. God bless you.
To thank Judy for all these kind of new ways of looking at things that are sort of ordinary, but it was very interesting. Please join me with our board affirmation for the month.
Unity of Kalamazoo as a magnetic and vibrant spiritual community spreading love, happiness, and joy. We are thrilled to begin our amazing journey together with our right and perfect new minister.
I don't think this microphone's on, maybe. Anyway, everyone at home and everyone here, please get out your tithes and offerings, and please join me in our offertory blessing. Divine love, through me, blesses and multiplies all that I am, all that I have, all that I give, and all that I receive.
Love is but a song I sing, and fears the way we die. You can make the mountains ring, or make the angels cry. Though the bird is on the wing, we may not know why. Surely pass. When the ones that left us here returns for us at last, we are but a moment's sunlight fading in the grass. Come on, people now, smile on your brother, everybody get together, try to love one another right now. And I said, come on, people now, smile on your brother, everybody get together, try to love one another right now. song I sing, you will understand. You hold the key to love and fear, all in your trembling hands. Just one key unlocks them both, they're at your command. So come on, people now, smile on brother, everybody get together. Gotta love one another right now. You can sing along, come on. Come on, people now, smile on your brother, everybody get together. Gotta love one another. Let's hear that again. Come on, people now, smile on your brother. Everybody get together. Try to love one another right now. And try to love one another right now. Try to love one another right now.
Brian. And as the ushers come forward, let us pray. Divine Spirit, we take this time to be aware and grateful of our many blessings. Our tithes and love offerings are given with gratitude and love for our church community in order that we may continue our work here in Kalamazoo and throughout the world. Amen. And as we bring our service to a close, I would like to encourage you all to attend next week for a special announcement. And now, would you please stand and join in our prayer for protection? The light of God surrounds us, the love of God enfolds us, the power of God protects us, and the presence of God watches over us. Wherever we are, God is, and all is well. And for our peace song, if you're comfortable, feel free to hold hands with your neighbor, or just place your hands on your heart and connect within.